Hey guys, welcome back. And I thought today I would film what I eat in a day on the keto diet to give you a little bit of an idea. And actually, I weighed myself today. Today is, when I'm filming this, is the 4th of January. I last weighed myself on December 31st. And when I weighed myself on December 31st, I was 143 pounds. Today, I am 135 pounds. At 8 pounds of water weight in just 5 days. Right. Okay. So let's talk about what I'm going to eat. I'm going to start off with my coffee. What I do with my coffee is I brew regular coffee. And then I add in, this is my favorite almond milk. It's flavored with salted caramel. This is Australia's own. I get mine at Coles. I'm not sure if I've, I don't think I've seen them at Woolies. This one contains, I don't know if you can actually see close enough what the stats are, but it's pretty low carb. Like for every 250 mils, there is 1 gram of carbs, and then fat is 4.2, protein is 1.5. And if you deduct the dietary fiber from the carbohydrate, there's 0.8 dietary fibers per 250 mils. So you actually only have 0.2 grams of carbs per 250 mils. And one of these things is a liter, so you can have 4. But I usually only use about 200 mils every time I make my coffee, so I can get 5 out of this. And as I'm filming this, it's currently on sale for $4. It's usually 6, so it's an expensive one, but it makes me want to drink coffee. So let me go ahead and show you. Now for the main meal, I am going to be cooking 2 strips of bacon and 2 eggs with 25 grams of cheese. I weigh my ingredients. And then I was initially thinking that I was going to be using 5 grams of these hemp heart toppers for that, but I looked at how much I was going to be, and it was going to be too much, so I decided to just do 2.5 grams. Now, just so you guys know, this is the I don't know if you can see that properly. I hope so. That's the macros for that. Each serving, which is 35 grams, which is way more than what I need, has got 11.7 grams of protein, 15.4 grams of fat, and carbs of 3.9 grams. That's a lot because it's 35 grams. I'm only using 2.5 grams on this particular one. So that's still going to be quite low carb. So yeah, let's get on with it. I'll show you how I make my breakfast. So because it's summer, for my morning coffee, I've actually put some ice in there, and then I've topped it with the almond milk. How beautiful is that? So now for the rest of breakfast, I've just weighed 25 grams of cheese. Yeah. Don't know if you can see that. There you go. 25 grams of cheese. It's too bright. I'm going to crack the 2 eggs in there. Make sure you don't get any of the yolk in. Of the shell, I mean. I did get a huge one there. Okay. Two eggs. Just gonna set that aside because I actually put the egg shells in my plants. Okay, now I think I fixed the brightness. So you've got 25 grams of cheese, cheddar cheese, shredded, 2 egg yolks in there. And now I'm gonna take my hemp heart seeds and use 5 grams of it. Oh, actually, 2.5 should be enough, because look at that, there's a lot in there. Yep, I think I'm gonna stick with just 2.5 grams of that hemp heart seed, because there's a lot. Now what I'm gonna do, just put this aside, so I'm gonna open my air fryer, put that in the air fryer, and then I've got my bacon here that is uncured. It's just like strips of bacon. I'm gonna take 2 strips. It's actually still stuck together. And I'm going to put that in the air fryer as well to cook with my beautiful egg. I don't know what to actually call this. Alright. Let me just wash my hands before I touch anything else. Turn this thing on. I can't seem to find which cable. Oh, here we go. I think this is the one. Yeah. And I'm going to leave that at 180 degrees, but for only 10 minutes. I'm just going to leave that to cook, and then I'll show you what it looks like afterwards. Okay, let's do a quick check. There's 2 minutes left. And that's what the egg looks like. Oh, it's overflowing at the moment because of the cheese, and the bacon is cooking pretty well. So I'm going to leave that to keep on cooking for the remaining 2 minutes. And my air fryer, by the way, is just from Kmart. It was $69. I mean, what does Kmart have? I think my microwave oven is also from Kmart. And they've also come out with their version of like an espresso machine for $89. Like, what? So this is my usual flat lay. Just to give you an idea of what this looks like inside. So you got your eggs and your cheese that overflowed all in there. All right. Bon appetit. This is going to keep me full for quite a while so that I wouldn't have to eat until later in the afternoon around 3 p.m. It is currently 10 a.m. I've been fasting since 8 p.m. last night. Okay, so it's lunchtime, and lunch today is actually very basic. In fact, it's a lunch that I commonly bring to work since I work in an office 9-to-5 kind of job. And I'm just having a cheese kransky, and one sausage this size is enough for me to feel full. But sometimes when I eat just meat and no other like sides or anything like that, it kind of like, because it's a very rich, oily kind of food, I feel like my palate needs a little bit of cleansing afterwards. So I actually made some of these sugar-free jellos. And the white stuff that you see on top is coconut oil that's solidified. So this is high in fat. There is like less than one sugar in all of this. Like if you add up all the sugar here, it's less than 1 gram. Because I used one packet of sugar-free jello. And this is the lime flavor, which is pretty good if you're trying to cleanse your palate and try to get that really rich, oily taste out of it. Okay, so that's what I'm having today. I'm probably going to have maybe 3 or 4 of those little jello shots and my cheese kransky. That's it. All right, so finally it's dinner time, and for the final meal of the night, it's a little bit later than usual. It's 8 p.m. and I usually have dinner at around 7, but because I actually just finished a Zumba class, so I'm having dinner now. So what do we have here? I've got my cauliflower rice, which you would have seen a video of me making last Sunday. I've got my, I've got buttered chicken that was made with Pete Evans buttered chicken sauce, and just some Greek yogurt over there. Okay, now according to my Fitness Pal, because I'm tracking my macros and everything, I've actually linked to my Fitbit on that, I would be consuming a total of 1,164 calories today, but my exercise, let me just see that, amounted to a total of, what happened here, 683, so I still have a deficit of 719 calories. But I'm not gonna eat 719 calories just to even it up, because the point is to lose weight, right? So it's good when you have a deficit. Anyway, That's what I eat in a day. This is just an example of what I normally eat in a day. If you like this video, let me know in the comment section down below, and I might try and do one every month just to like keep you updated on what I'm putting in me. All right, have a great day. Bye.